What is the mono center bus, how to send channels to it, how to route it to a physical XLR output so you can actually plug it into a loudspeaker or a subwoofer, what's the difference between left center right and left right plus mono, and finally how to cross over the mono bus with the main left right to separate the subwoofers from the mains.
This is the mono center bus, and it is not a matrix, okay? You can only send channels to it. You cannot send buses to it. And hypothetically, if you're running out of buses and you still have one extra output on the back of the console, you can use this one as a normal mix bus like these. The only difference is that with the mono bus, you cannot tap the signal. Okay, so with these buses, you can go here and say that I want the channels to come pre-EQ or post-EQ or pre-fader or post-fader. With this one, you cannot do that. Just the same way like the main left-right, you can also not do that. The bus is always post-fader.
You can think of the mono center bus as a main bus. It behaves very similarly to the main left and right. The main left and right has two channels, a left and the right, and the mono bus is that third channel of that whole mix.
There are two different ways to send channels to the mono bus. First way is to select the mono bus, then turn on flip fader, then you're gonna unmute the channels that you want to be sent to that bus, then you're gonna raise the faders on these channels, and then turn off the flip fader button. This is very important. I cannot stress that enough. When you're done, turn it off, because if you don't, you're gonna mess up your mix and you don't want that. If you forget to turn this off, you can do it the second way, which is in the main bus section. So you're gonna select the channel now and go here and turn on mono center, and then turn the encoder, and that is sending the channel to the mono bus.
Okay, now that you have channels on that bus, you still need to route it to a physical XLR output so you can actually connect it to a loudspeaker.
Go to routing, then go to the right, to the out page, and by default, outputs 15 and 16 are for the main left and right. 15 is the left and 16 is the right, and I'm gonna put the mono bus on output number 14. So I'm gonna select it, then go here to the main LCR, and choose main center and assign it. And now this mono bus is going out of output 14, the XLR output 14 on the back of the console. And if you want, you can tap the signal coming out of the mono bus in case you're using it as a regular mix bus. But if you're using it alongside the main left and right for extra subwoofers, I would suggest you just keep it post fader. It's a better idea to just keep it this way.
Okay, great, but we're not done yet, because if you notice, the bus is called mono slash center. It has two different names, and it's not for your convenience to call it whatever you like. It's two different things. Mono and center are not the same thing. So what's the difference between left right plus mono and left center right?
Go to setup, then go to the right, to the configuration page, and under panning mode, you're gonna see left, right, plus sub, and left, center, right. Now, in most cases, when you're doing gigs and live concerts and music, you're gonna use left, right, plus sub, because it makes sense. You have a left speaker and a right speaker, that's your stereo mix, and you have an extra subwoofer for bass. Left, center, right requires you to have an actual center speaker that is not a subwoofer. And I'll explain the difference between these two. So let's start with left, right, plus sub. I'm gonna select a channel, then click view under the main bus section. And this shows me the levels that go into the left speaker, into the subwoofer, and into the right speaker. So if I raise the fader on this channel, it will affect the level that goes into the left and right speakers. Okay, cool. If I turn on the mono bus and turn it up, I'm now sending this channel to the subwoofers. And this is completely independent of the left and right. It does not affect the left and right in any way. Now, the fader of this channel affects all three of them equally, okay? But the center one does not affect the left and right. Cool. Now, if I go to the setup page again and I say left, center, right, and I go to the main page again, now the center bus affects the left and right. If I push it more in the center, it will lower the left and right. If I reduce it in the center, it will lift the left and right. If you're doing music, don't use that, it will confuse you.
Okay, great, now you're sending the kick drum, the bass guitar, and maybe a bass synth to that mono bus that is going into the subwoofers. But the mono bus itself doesn't automatically cut off the high frequencies. So here's how to cross over the subs with the main.
You're gonna select the mono bus, then go to the EQ, turn it on, and click on view, then click on the high button, and make sure it's a high cut. Then go here and lower the frequency till around 100 Hertz. Anywhere between 80 and 100 is a good starting point. And it all depends on the speakers you're using. Okay, so check the specs of your speakers to know the cutoff frequency. I will select 85 for this example. Then I'm gonna go to the main left right, select it, and turn on the EQ. And now I'm gonna choose low cut. Okay, low cut, and go to that same frequency, 85. Okay, so we're cutting off the mono bus and the left right at the same frequency.
It's also not a bad idea to cut a little bit of low frequencies on the subs. Yes, I said it, because the lowest frequency you're gonna have to deal with in a live situation with a live band is around 50 Hertz or maybe 45 Hertz if you have a huge kick drum. Okay, but unless you're doing electronic dance music, you don't need all these low frequencies, the 20 and 30 Hertz.
I'm gonna select the mono bus again and then go to the EQ on the low, make sure it's a low cut, and then cut anywhere between 30 and 35 Hertz. I personally think it sounds cleaner and punchier. You don't have to do it, but it's probably not a bad idea. And if you want a steeper cut, you can change the modes right here till you get a steeper cut.
There's one more very important thing I need to say, but before that, go ahead and hit the like button if you're finding this video helpful so far. I'm waiting. Okay, now that we set the correct range of frequencies to go to the correct speaker, this ensures that first of all, we don't hurt the speakers. Second of all, we are avoiding phasing problems. But this alone doesn't prevent phasing problems, because if the subwoofers are at a different distance from the main speakers, they will phase. So you need to time align the subs to the mains. And if you don't know how to do that, click right here to know how to do output delays and align speakers, and I'll see you there.